You know, the last 12 months were about me finding myself. I came to NXT wanting to make an impact, obsessed with impressing people, getting people to like me. I wanted people to think, damn, Cora Jade is the next big superstar here at NXT.
Cora, you are the future of the NXT women's division.
But somehow, I wasn't seen that way.
But the future is bleak.
To be honest, it messed with me a little bit. Got in my head and probably cost me those early title matches. It all clicked for me in my match with Natty. It was one hell of a match. And yeah, I lost. But I left that ring with Natty's respect. You know, I was sitting in the locker room thinking, screw what people think, I'm a star. And my best friend was coming in the door. I'm not gonna sit here and waste any more of my TV time on that piece of trash. We know the story. Everyone loves Roxanne, even though she proved that she's a loser. We love her. Good job, Roxanne. Back to the more important things now here, me. I'm living my best life. I don't need anyone's approval, especially these fans. Have you heard these morons? They have the education level of a second grader. And as for the locker room, you seriously think I care what somebody like Zoe Stark thinks? My shoe has more personality than her. Nikita Lyons? Way too cocky. Girl, you ain't that good. Lash, annoying. Indy's lost. Alba's just weird. And Toxic Attraction, I still don't like them, but now I understand them. And Wendy too? Wendy makes me laugh. She's like a human stuffed animal. Kind of pathetic, kind of feel bad for her. She doesn't belong in a ring. She belongs in the corner of a baby's playroom. Thanks, guys. Can't wait to do this interview again on the 2-year anniversary, because the Generation of Jade is only gonna get bigger, my star is only gonna shine brighter, and by this time next year, I will be the number one woman in this entire industry.